Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's a Uni-T UT622 AC millivolt meter. It is a current product, so you can buy this today in the year 2023. It's about $300 on AliExpress at the moment. So you better go for it. I don't know. This millivolt meter got 12 level ranges for each of the two channels. And as you see here, the finest range is 1 millivolt and the highest is 300 volts. It is very, very hard to read this text, even on the camera, but also in real life. I don't know why they made it this shitty. But that is how it looks like, right? So we got two inputs, and the whole idea about this meter is the two needles, as you can see here from the side. It's easy to see we got two different needles, and the idea is you can compare a left and right channel of audio equipment or input and output of compressor, limiters and such, and that is exactly what my father used to use this unit for. It should cover a frequency range from 10 hertz to 2 megahertz. I can't wait to see if that is really true. And this one is not the standard version, I guess. I think this one is upgraded with outputs, because normally you don't really see those outputs as well. And this should only use a couple of watts, so I don't know. That's probably just the fuse. How about we just try and power it up and see what happens, right? Before we open this thing. So let's try and power it. Yes, there's not a lot. Really? So there's a relay in here. Why is it doing this? So now I'm testing at 1 kilohertz just for fun. I got a 50 ohm load, one of those feed through loads here, and my signal generator is set up for 50 ohm load. So that means I have much better control of the level at exactly this port, because this input here is a high impedance kind of port. So that means I set my signal generator for 1 volt RMS, and then I get this readout, and it's tiny, tiny little bit lower. But I think it is because this impedance plus this impedance and so on, right? So this is channel 2. Let's try the other channel. And see, it is exactly the same readout. So that is fantastic. And that is of course the 1 volt full range kind of. So all that is great. So what if I go to the next level? So that is this one, right? And then it is exactly the same. So that was 1 kilohertz. Okay, let me go back here. I think what I really wanted to test, that was just the frequency range just for fun. So if we just keep the level and then I put in 10 hertz. Ooh, we get a tiny little bit more. That's interesting. And what if I dial it up to 20? Here we go. Yeah, a tiny little bit more, and so that was like, so let's 500 hertz, and that is the same level as 1 kilohertz. Okay, let's go to 10 kilohertz, and then it's a little bit up. Yeah, so there is a little bit of frequency variation. 20 kilohertz, let's just crank it all the way up to 100 kilohertz. 2, 3, 4, 5, 100 kilohertz. And now I will expect to see. So yeah, it goes a little bit up. So that is 1.2 megahertz. Oy, oy, oy. Look at that. That is 2 megahertz and it goes positive. That's 3 megahertz. Whoa, it was only specified for 2 megahertz. And then, oy, 3.4. And then goes down, down, down. 5 megahertz. 6. 7. Oh, let's try something real funny and see if this is exactly the same per channel. So we'll leave it here. This is 5.7 megahertz. 1 volt RMS input. Let's see what happens if I test the other. Yeah, exactly. So that is 0.5. And that one is 0.6. So it's very much the same. But how about I go back to 2 megahertz? That is the specified frequency range, right? We need to be fair here. So now it is almost 1.1. And then, yeah, you see? Now it's not super duper tracking. And let's go about back to 1 megahertz. And then it is very close to 1. And then this is a little bit more. So it's not insanely accurate at extreme frequencies. Okay, so let's go back to 20 kilohertz and then compare. That is 1 point a little bit. And then, no, it's just, well, that is how it is. It is not super duper duper. But I mean, $300, that is also a little bit of money, isn't it? Maybe it's just me, but I kind of expected a little bit more from this at kind of that price. Let's see what's inside, shall we? Let's look a little bit more inside here. And of course, there's a chassis wire here that is a little bit annoying. So somebody cut this, solder it again, and then put a little rubber isolation here. Because it's super, super annoying. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to desolder that one. So that means we can remove the lid. Now we can play around on the inside of this unit. And we got open switches with a nice ground shield in the middle. And that shield is not connected to anything. That is a little bit unexpected. I would expect to see a wire from this one to chassis. And we got some, there's a little speed up capacitor here to handle frequency range. We got a, ooh, what is that down here? Look at that. That looks like an antenna. Well, that is a frequency compensation. So you kind of wind this for the correct frequency compensation for both channels. There's probably also one on the other side. Yes, indeed, there is. Isn't that fantastic? So here is the other channel. And I, if I'm not mistaken, normally those meters like this, they use a completely mirrored board layout so that everything here is completely mirrored. So let's have a look if this is also the case on this unit. Is this PCB called something else? Like this channel this or channel that? 08047, right? So let's have a look at the other channel. See, there is another PCB layout. It is not the same number as the other one. And that is because it's a completely mirrored layout. It's also a number two here. Let's see again all the components. We got the relay at the top, regulator here, and nicely aligned components and all that kind of stuff. So let's look at the other channel. See? Ha! It is completely mirrored. And there's probably a number one somewhere here, right? No, there's not. So here we go. Output AC output after the amplifiers. And B and C connectors on the back. It is quite neatly made. And so this meter is actually a double meter, and they are mounted behind each other. We are of course not going to open this because it is a completely sealed instrument, and I'm not going to break it or anything because it actually works more or less. Yeah, this case here is a little bit flimsy. Those screws are a little bit loose, and you know, what do you think? Look also at the transformer that is hanging a little bit. Yeah, so now it's nicely in the middle again. There's probably transport dropped. And then there is a metal isolation between the two channels. And that is what there is to say about this thing. I didn't expect to make a long, complicated video or anything. It's not a super complicated instrument, but this is $300. Two little PCBs with like 10 transistors, more or less, right? And a little relay for something. I don't know actually what it is. Oh yes, of course, the relay probably, let's see, shorts the meters so they're not going crazy when you transport it. And oh, did I forget to say this unit uses or consumes 5.6 watts from your mains input. That is it, really. Not a lot. So you can leave it on the whole day. Well, that was it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon, okay? Bye-bye!